Hello and welcome back to MechZone. As you all are aware that we have already finished with the theory section on our channel, and now we shall be starting with the problem solving lectures as promised by us. So what we will be doing is we will be solving about 500 assorted problems from each subject, covering each and every topic in that particular subject. And these problems will include the multiple choice questions, the subjective questions or the conventional questions from almost all the examinations related to mechanical engineering. So today we shall be starting with the first subject, that is thermodynamics. And in thermodynamics, we shall be starting with the first chapter, that is the basic concepts and the zeroth law of thermodynamics. And the first section that we will be solving is fill in the blanks and choose the correct one option. So let's get started. So here in this section, we have been asked about the fill in the blanks, and these questions are very, very direct and very simple. However, they can be directly asked in either of the interviews also, and we have included these questions in our lecture. So if we look at the first statement, it says a closed system is one which allows. Now we know in case of a closed system, there is only the transfer of energy but no transfer of mass. And hence, a closed system is one which allows only energy transfer. So it would be a system which would allow only energy transfer. Okay, so the closed system is one which allows only the transfer of energy and there will be no transfer of mass. Now the second question is the zeroth law of thermodynamics deals with. Now let us quickly revise what was the zeroth law of thermodynamics. For example, we have three bodies, say body A, body B and body C, such that A and C were in thermal equilibrium with each other, B and C were also in thermal equilibrium with each other, then according to the zeroth law of thermodynamics, A and B will also be in thermal equilibrium with each other. So this is nothing but this is the zeroth law of thermodynamics, and the zeroth law of thermodynamics hence deals with the thermal equilibrium. So zeroth law of thermodynamics actually establishes the thermal equilibrium. The next question is boiler, turbine and condenser are dash systems, whereas the thermal power plant can be taken as a dash system. Now in case of boiler, turbine and condenser, mass and energy transfer both can take place, and hence this boiler, turbine or condenser are nothing but they are type of open systems, whereas the thermal power plant on the whole can be considered as a closed system. Okay, now next is when a system is divided into two equal parts, then the intensive property, please mind, then the intensive property divides into two parts or remains unchanged. Now we know that in case of the intensive property, which is independent of mass, intensive property is nothing but independent of mass. So there is no dependency on mass and hence there will be no change. So the correct option would be it remains unchanged. Now next question is 1 Kelvin is defined as. Now in the theory lectures we have already defined 1 Kelvin and it is defined as 1 upon 273.16 of the triple point of water. Triple point of water. So 1 Kelvin is nothing but it is defined as the 1 upon 273.16 of the triple point of water. Now the next question that has been asked to us is the triple point of water is, that means we have to tell the triple point temperature of water and also the triple point pressure of water. Okay, so the triple point of water we have already defined in the above question, so it would be 2 273.16 Kelvin, and the triple point pressure of water is nothing but 0.61 kilopascal. So we need to remember all these values. Now let us do the another question. Now we have been asked about this question, and it says the dash thermometer is independent of the working fluid. Now we have already studied in the theory chapters that an ideal gas thermometer, is actually independent of the working fluid. Okay, so the answer is ideal gas thermometer. Everything external to the system is called as. Now, what was system? System was actually the part of the universe which was considered for analysis, and except the system, everything becomes the surrounding. And the cover or the portion which surrounds the system is called as the boundary. So boundary is actually differentiating the system from its surrounding. Now extensive property is one which is. Now we have been asked about the extensive property, and the extensive property is one which is definitely dependent on mass. Dependent on mass. So there will be a mass dependency in case of the extensive property. Next is heat and work are. Now we know that heat and work both are actually path functions. Okay, so they are path functions. That means they both are path dependent. They are path dependent and they are inexact differential. Inexact differential simply means that the integral from 1 to 2 dq would not be equals to q2 minus q1. This is called as the inexact differential, and they also depend upon the past history. Since they are path dependent, so they will also depend upon the path history. Now heat, volume, pressure, temperature is not a property. Out of these four, one is not a property. Now we know that in volume, pressure and temperature, these are actually the properties, but heat is not a property, rather it is a path function. So heat is a path function. It is not a property. Next, the dash property is used in the thermocouple. So the property which is used in the thermocouple is nothing but it is the voltage, or more precisely speaking, it is called as the EMF or the electromotive force. Now the next question that we have been asked is dash temperature has the same value for centigrade as well as for the Fahrenheit. Now in order to solve this question, we must have an idea of the formula which is being used. So the formula that is used to convert between Fahrenheit and Celsius is C upon 5 is equals to F minus 32 upon 9. So this is the formula which will be used, and here we have to keep C is equals to F. So the temperature that would be is minus 40. So minus 40 is the temperature which is having the same value for centigrade as well as for the Fahrenheit scale. Now let us come to the second section of our problem solving lecture, and here we shall be doing or solving the multiple choice questions where we will be given more than one option, and out of those there will be actually four options, and out of those four options only one will be correct. So we have to find out which one is the correct option. Okay, so the first multiple choice question that we have to solve is, we have been given ammonia and water mixture existing in two phases in equilibrium has dash number of independent properties. Now this question is nothing but a direct question from the Gibbs phase rule, which states that P plus F is equals to C plus 2. So we have to find out the number of independent properties, and the number of independent properties is nothing but the degree of freedom. Now it states that ammonia and water, that means we have two chemical components, so the value of C becomes 2, exist in two phases, that means P is also equals to 2. Okay, so here if we keep the value of P, that is 2 plus F would be equals to 2 plus 2, so from here the degree of freedom is coming out to be 2. So degree of freedom can also be defined as the number of independent intensive properties which are required to fix the state of the system, or nothing but these are the independent properties. So we have been asked here about the degree of freedom. Now out of the given options, the following are intensive properties. Now we have been asked about the intensive properties. Intensive properties are those which are independent of mass. Now let us go for the first option, that is pressure and specific enthalpy. Definitely pressure and specific enthalpy we look at, both appears to be correct option, because pressure and specific, the word specific itself indicates that this is an intensive property, and pressure is 100% an intensive property. So this option is correct. However, we shall also be checking the other options. Now we have energy. Energy is not an intensive property. However, if we would have been given specific energy, then it would have been a intensive property. Next is volume and pressure. Volume is not an intensive property. Next we have pressure. Here it was intensive, but volume becomes extensive, so this option is also wrong. Next we have energy and specific enthalpy. Specific enthalpy is an intensive property, but energy is not an intensive property. Now the next question that has been given to us, the graph is drawn from the constant volume gas thermometer as shown in the figure, and we have to determine the value of A which is asked in the diagram. Okay, so this question has been given to us where we need to determine the value of this A. Now the graph is drawn for a constant volume gas thermometer. We have already discussed in the theory section that this temperature where the A is intersecting the temperature axis is nothing but, it is called 0 Kelvin, or 0 Kelvin, or nothing but minus 273.15 degree centigrade. So this is minus 273.15 degree centigrade because this scale has been given in degree centigrade. Now this is the temperature at which all molecular motion ceases. Okay, so this answer, minus 273.15 degree centigrade, is the correct answer. Okay, the next question that has been given to us is, which among the following is not a property? Actually this question has been repeated. So we have already observed that heat is not a property, it is actually a path function. So heat is not a property and it is a path function. In one of the interviews, public sectors of BEL, it was asked from one of the candidate whether work is a property or not. He said work is not a property. So what is work? Work is also a path function. It all depends upon your presence of mind, whether you are in a tension mode or whether you are in a light mode, then only you will be able to answer. You have to keep yourself very calm while you are giving an interview. Next is the thermodynamic property used in the thermocouple. We have already seen that this property is the EMF. Now next question, the Fahrenheit scale shows 98.6 degrees centigrade on the Fahrenheit scale. Now what we have to do is we have to find out the temperature that would be equal to on the centigrade scale. Okay, so here in this question what we will do is we will again apply the formula C upon 5 is equals to F minus 32 upon 9. Now we will keep the value of F is equals to 98.6 and the value of C that will be evaluated here. You can evaluate it by yourself. The answer is coming out to be 37 degree centigrade. So the correct option is option number B. Now the next question that we have, an oil of specific gravity is also called as relative density, and relative density is a unitless quantity. Why? Because it is the ratio of two similar type of quantities, that is the density. So we have been given the relative density S, which is equals to 0.8, and depth has been given as 80 centimeter, or this can be written as 0.8 meter. Now we know, determine the gauge pressure. Now here we have to determine the gauge pressure at this point. Now we know that gauge pressure would be P is equals to H rho G. So the value of H that will be used here is 0.8 rho. Rho means the density. Density would be 0.8 into 1000. Why 1000? Because relative density is expressed with respect to water. And the value of G would be used here is 9.81 meters per second square. So on solving this, we will obtain the value of pressure as 6.278.4 pascal. So 6278.4 pascal, that will be the value which is obtained. We have to convert it into kilopascal. So the correct answer that will be obtained here is 6.28 kilopascal, or simply kilonewton per meter square. Now in the above question, if the atmospheric pressure is 760 mm of Hg, find the absolute pressure. We know that P absolute is equals to P gauge plus P atmospheric. P gauge pressure we have already obtained, 6.28 plus atmospheric pressure 760 mm of Hg. So we have to convert it into the absolute value. So the absolute value would be 760 divided by 1000 H. Ye ho gaya H divided by 1000 because we have to convert it into meter. Rho of the mercury would be 13600 and G would be 9.81. So on solving this and adding to 6.28, we will obtain 107.68 kilopascal. So this is the correct answer. Now the next question that we have is, for a closed system, however this question is from the first law, but we haven't included it here, so never mind. So for the closed system, the difference between the heat added and the work done is equal to. Now from the first law of thermodynamics, we know that del Q is equals to du plus del W. Now the difference, if we take delta W on this side, we have del Q minus del W would be equals to du, and du is nothing but the internal energy. So this is the correct answer. Okay, the next question that we have is, the cyclic integral or in a cyclic process dash is zero. Now this question is again from the first law of thermodynamics. So in a cyclic process, the correct answer would be cyclic integral of an intensive property is zero. Okay, next is option se dekh lete hain. Option bhi diya hua hai, work transfer, heat transfer, change in the internal energy, and all the variables are zero. Now cyclic integral of work transfer is not zero. Cyclic integral of heat transfer is also not zero, but if we look at this option, we have internal energy, and internal energy being a property, and hence the cyclic integral of DE would be equals to 0. That means cyclic integral of delta Q minus cyclic integral of delta W would be equals to cyclic integral of DE, which is nothing but 0. So the answer is change in internal energy, that is U. Next question that we have, match the following correct choices. We have a jet flight, water heated in a sealed container, internal energy and specific entropy. Okay, so if we look specific entropy, the word specific itself indicate that it is an intensive property. Okay, it is an intensive property. But if we look here on the right hand side, we have no options such as intensive property. So let us go for the internal energy. So internal energy, we know that the cyclic integral is 0 because internal energy is an intensive property. So C can be matched with 3. So we have C 3. Next we have water heated in a sealed container. Now the word sealed itself means that it is a closed system, and hence B would be 1. Now a jet engine flight is actually an example of the open system. This I have already taught in the lectures. A is 2, so remaining D would be 4. This question was actually asked in one of the, I think it was asked in the MPPSC examination, and this was quite confusing because specific entropy, D is 4, it is not an extensive property, it is definitely an intensive property because the word specific is coming here. But since the options are given like this, so we have to choose this answer. So this was the match the column. Now we have next match the column, and in this match the column we have been given in the left hand side mercury in glass, thermocouple, thermistor and constant volume. So these are the type of thermometers. Okay, now we have to find out the thermometric property which is governing the use of that particular thermometer. If we look mercury in glass, now mercury in glass is nothing but the thermometric property that is used here is volume. So A would be 3. Now in case of thermocouple, we have already seen that it is voltage or EMF. So B becomes 4. Next is thermistor. Now in case of the thermistor, we have the thermometric property which is the resistance, that is C would be 2. And in the constant volume, the thermometric property is pressure. So D is 1. So the correct option would be A3, B2, A3, B4, C2 and D1. Now we will solve the conventional or the subjective types of problems. These types of problems are asked in GATE, SSC JE and ESE as well. So we'll be elevating our level from very easy to quite tough problems. So the first problem that we have is the temperature difference of 10 degree centigrade of 10 degree on the centigrade scale corresponds to the change of dash on the Fahrenheit scale. Now if we remember our Fahrenheit scale and our degree centigrade scale, so in case of the degree centigrade scale, the ice point is 0 degree and the steam point is 100 degree. Whereas in case of the degree Fahrenheit scale, the ice point is taken as 32 degree Fahrenheit and the steam point is taken as 212 degree Fahrenheit. Now the difference, if we see the difference on the centigrade scale is of 100 units, whereas the difference in case of Fahrenheit, it is nothing but about So I'll once again solve this problem for the convenience. We have been asked that a difference of 10 degree on the centigrade scale would correspond to a change of dash on the Fahrenheit scale. Now in the Fahrenheit scale, we have ice point as 32 degree Fahrenheit and steam point as 212 degree Fahrenheit. Whereas in case of the degree centigrade, we have 0 degree as the ice point and 100 degree as the steam point. So a change of 100 degree on the centigrade scale is actually corresponding to a change of 180 degree on the Fahrenheit scale. So we simply have to apply the unitary method and we will find that a change of 10 degree on the centigrade scale is actually corresponding to a change of 18 degree on the Fahrenheit scale. So the answer to this question is 18. Now to solve another important problem, okay, and this problem states that a new temperature scale is to be designed degree T such that the boiling and the freezing points are 100 and 400 degree T respectively. Now we have to find out the reading on the new scale corresponding to 60 degree centigrade. Now when I was discussing the theory, I have already explained you the formula to interconnect the two temperature scales. And the formula is T minus T ice upon TS minus TI on the arbitrary temperature scale degree T. This would be equals to T minus TI upon TS minus TI on the degree centigrade scale. Now TI is the ice point, TS is the steam point. Now in the degree T centigrade, let us put these values. We have to find out the reading on the new scale, which is corresponding to 60 degree centigrade. That means we have to find out this T. So T minus T ice point has been given as, see, boiling point has been given as 100 T and the freezing point is 400. So we have to keep it 400 here. TS is 100 minus 400. This on the arbitrary temperature scale T would be equals to this T. What would be the value of this T? It has been given as 60 minus T ice. Ice point on the degree centigrade is 0. Steam point is 100 minus 0. So if we further solve, it would be T minus 400 upon minus 300. This would be 60 upon 100. So 0 gets cancelled out, and when we will solve, the value of T is coming out to be nothing but it is, we will obtain as 220 degree T. So the value which will be obtained here is 220 degree T. So the formula that will be used here is T minus TI upon TS minus TI on the degree T scale would be equals to T minus TI upon TS minus TI on the degree centigrade scale. Okay. And in the formula, we have to keep the appropriate value such that this T would be equals to 60 because this is corresponding to the temperature on the centigrade scale. And after putting the values, we will obtain the answer as 220 degree T. Now, the next part of the question that we have been asked here is, at what temperature both Celsius and the new temperature scale show the same reading? Okay, now we have to find out the value of that temperature at which the degree T scale temperature would be equals to the degree centigrade scale temperature. Okay, so we will again apply that formula, T minus TI upon TS minus TI on the degree T scale, that would be equals to T minus TI upon TS minus TI on the degree centigrade scale. Now since both the temperatures are having the same value, so we will keep T of the degree T would be equals to T of degree centigrade scale, such that on the degree centigrade degree T scale, we had Ti was equals to 100 and T steam was equals to 400 degree T. And on the other hand, whereas Ti would be equals to 0 degree centigrade and T steam would be equals to 100 degree centigrade on the centigrade scale. So we will keep these values in this formula and we will obtain T is equals to 100 degree. So a temperature of 100 degree would have the same value on the degree T scale as well as on the degree centigrade scale. Now this is a very important problem which we will be discussing now. So we have been given the reading TA and TB for a Celsius thermometer A and B. There are two different thermometers such that they are working on the Celsius scale, and at ice and steam point they read some temperature. That means the thermometer A is dipped in the ice whereas the thermometer B is dipped in the steam. So the temperature that will be recorded by A would be 0 degree centigrade and the temperature that would be recorded by steam would be 100 degree centigrade. Okay, now the temperature is related by this formula of TA is equals to M plus L plus MTB plus NTB square, where L, M and N are taken as constants. Now when both are immersed in air, A reads 51 degree centigrade. Now the reading, new reading of A is 51 degree centigrade and the reading of B is 50 degree centigrade. We have to determine the reading A when B reads 25 degree. Okay, so this is the question. Now what we will do is we will write down TA is equals to L plus MTB plus NTB square. Now in this equation, let us first put these values. Okay, A 0, TA means temperature by A, which is the ice temperature, which is 0. L plus M into the value of TB is 100 plus N into 100 square. Okay, so by putting these values, we will now get that the value, there is actually an error in this question. We just have to correct it. The error is the reading T and TB for the Celsius thermometer A and B. A and B are showing same reading. Actually, A and B are showing same readings at ice and steam point. This is the line that we have missed. So A and B are showing the same reading at ice and the steam points. That means when A and B both will be dipped in the ice, the reading of A would be 0 and the reading of B would also be 0. So let us clear it out. Okay. And we will solve this question again because this is an important question and it may be asked in the examination. So now let us write down this equation. TA is equals to L plus MTB plus NTB square. Now let us first put the temperature of A equals to temperature of B equals to 0 degree centigrade. So 0 is equals to L plus 0 plus N into 0 square. So from here we will evaluate L is equals to 0. Okay, this is the first equation. Now since there are three unknowns, we will have three equations. The unknowns are L, M and N. So three equations have to be there. The second equation is we will keep TA equals to TB equals to 100 degrees. So we will obtain 100 is equals to L plus m into 100 plus n into 100 square. Now we have already evaluated as L equals to 0. So the second equation that will be obtained would be m plus 100n is coming out to be 1. So this is the equation number 2. Now what we will do is we will use this data to form the equation number 3. That means when TA is equals to 51, 51 is equals to L plus M into TB. TB is 50 plus N into 50 square. L we have evaluated as 0. So from this equation, if we simplify, we will get finally the value of M would be 1.04 and the value of N would be minus 4 into 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, so the value of these constants will be evaluated as 1.04 and minus 4 into 10 to the power minus 4. Now we have to find out the temperature of A when TB is equals to 25 degrees centigrade. Now keep TB is equals to 25 degrees centigrade in this equation. Keep L is equals to 0, M is equals to 1.04 and N is equals to minus 4 into 10 to the power 4. We will obtain the final answer. TA is nothing but coming out to be about 25.75 degree centigrade. So the only correction in this question that we have done is A and B are reading the same temperature for ice and steam point. That means if A is reading 0 degree centigrade for the ice point, B will also read 0 degree for the ice point. And if A is reading 100 degree centigrade for the steam point, then B will also read the 100 degree centigrade for the steam point. And we have three unknowns, so we will have three equations. Equation number 1 that we have obtained here, equation number 2, and here we had equation number 3. So all these equations will be solved and the value of the constants will be obtained. And by keeping the values of these constants in this equation and keeping TB is equals to 25 because it has been given, we will obtain the value of TA, which is equals to 25.75 degree C. Okay, now let us do the another question which has been asked, and it says that a heavy truck of mass 1200 kg is traveling at a speed of 90 km per hour, impacts a plunger which is attached to a piston cylinder arrangement. Now if all the energy of the truck is absorbed by the 100 kg of the liquid which is contained in the cylinder, then find out the maximum rise in the temperature of liquid if the specific heat is given as 4.0 kilojoule per kg degree of Celsius. Okay, now let us suppose that we have a piston cylinder arrangement like this, okay, and we have a very heavy truck, okay, which is traveling towards this piston cylinder arrangement such that the velocity has been given as 90 km per hour and the mass has been given as 1200 kg. Now when the collision or the impact is taking place between this truck and the piston cylinder arrangement, the energy is imparted to this system, and as a result of which the piston cylinder arrangement now transfers the energy to the fluid which is contained in this piston cylinder arrangement. Okay, so this is the situation. Now the energy that will be transferred from this truck to this piston cylinder arrangement would definitely result in the temperature rise for this liquid. Now we have to find out what would be the rise in temperature of this particular liquid. Now this problem can be solved very easily by simply considering one fact or one assumption rather, and the assumption would be the energy of the truck is completely transferred to the energy of the liquid. So while moving, the truck is actually having the kinetic energy. The truck is having the kinetic energy. Okay, so kinetic energy would be half m v square, half m. m has been given as 1200. Now we have to keep the velocity in meter per second. So we will convert 90 kilometer per hour. So I'll give you a shortcut. 90 kilometer per hour into meter per second. Now we are converting from larger unit to a smaller unit. So we will multiply it by smaller upon larger value. For example, if we would have to convert 90 meter per second to kilometer per hour, then we are going from the smaller value to a larger value. So we will multiply it by larger upon smaller number. So here we will be multiplying 90 into 5 by 18. This 18 5s are, this becomes 25 meters per second. So the kinetic energy would be half into 1200 into 25 square. Okay, this would be the kinetic energy of the truck which will be delivered to the piston cylinder arrangement. Okay. Now the energy that will be imparted to the piston cylinder arrangement, it will be used as heat energy, and this heat energy will raise the temperature. So half into 1200 into 25 square would be equals to mc delta t of the liquid. M has been given as 100 kg of the liquid. C has been given as 4.0 kilojoule. Okay, it has been given as 4.0 kilojoule. So we will convert it into joule, and delta t. So after solving, we will obtain that delta t is nothing but it is coming out to be somewhere around 0.9375 degree C. So this is the final answer. So nothing we have done special, it is simply the energy transformation. It is the case of energy transformation. That means the energy is here transforming from the kinetic energy into the heat energy of this liquid. So this is the question. This is also a very simple question, and it can also be asked in any of the examinations. Now let us solve this question, where we have been given a titanium jar of 0.4 meter cube capacity. That means the volume has been given as 0.4 meter cube. Store is used to store an explosive gas at 100 bar and 27 degree Celsius. That means pressure has been given as 100 bar and temperature has been given as 27 degree Celsius, means 300 Kelvin. We always take the temperature in Kelvin, or we can say we know that 1 bar is nothing but 10 to the power 5 Pascal. 1 bar is nothing but 10 to the power 5 Pascal, but let us for now keep the temperature in bar only. The jar is to be protected against the excessive pressure by means of a fusible plug which melts and allow the gas to escape if the temperature is too high. Now if the temperature inside the jar is very too high, the fusible plug would melt and it would allow the gas to go out. This would prevent the excessive building of pressure inside a jar. Now the temperature at which the fusible plug must melt in order to limit the pressure of the jar to a value of 150 bar. Okay. Now we have to find that value of the temperature at which the fusible plug will melt in order to limit the pressure. In order to limit the pressure, what we need to have is, we need to have a certain mechanism that would not allow the pressure to be raised to a very appreciable value, or simply we can say that volume would be a constant parameter. Okay, so it would be an isochoric process. Now since volume is constant, we can have P1 upon T1 is equals to P2 upon T2. So the value of P1 is 100 bar, the value of T1 is 300 Kelvin, the value of P2 is 150 bar, and the value of T2 is unknown. So from here we can find out the value of T2, and it is coming out to be approximately 177 degree centigrade. However, since we are not given any unit in which the answer is asked, so we can report the answer either in 177 degree centigrade or in Kelvin also. So this question is also very important. The last line, that is the temperature at which the fusible plug must melt in order to limit the pressure. Kuch log yahan pe isobaric process bhi laga denge, yani pressure ko limit kar diya, matlab pressure change nahi hoga. Lekin agli line mein you will see that it has been limited to a value of 150 bar. That means by keeping the volume to be constant, the pressure can also be limited to a specified value. And hence we will apply P1 upon P2 would be equals to T1 upon T2. Okay. Now, the next question that we have been asked is a very simple question, which is from a direct physics of class 11th and 12th. And we have been given the air contained in a well-insulated room is circulated by means of an electric blower of 0.5 horsepower. Now, 1 horsepower is equal to 746 watt or 746 joule per second. We have to remember this data. Now it is having an efficiency of 65%. As we know, then that efficiency is nothing but the ratio of power output upon power input. This has been given as 65% or nothing but 0.65. Okay. Find out the rate of energy which is being supplied to the room. We have to find out the rate of power or energy which is being supplied to the room. Okay. Now, electric blower is taking 0.5 horsepower. It means the data that has been given to us is nothing but the power which is being output. Jitna hume mil raha hai, that is given as 0.65. Okay, sorry, that is given as 0.5 horsepower. So 1 horsepower is equals to 746 watt. So 0.5 horsepower would be equals to nothing but 373 watt. Okay, so efficiency is equals to power output, which is given as 373 watt divided by power input. So power input is unknown here. So in order to find out the power input, we have 373 divided by 0.65. so the answer is coming out to be about, okay, so if we calculate, the answer is coming out to be 573.84 joule per second, or the answer can also be reported as 0.574 kilojoule per second, or kilojoule per second is nothing but the kilowatt. So these were the all problems that we have to study in the zeroth law of thermodynamics. However, we have covered the subjective problems as well as the objective problems from the first chapter, that is the basic concepts and the zeroth law of thermodynamics. Now in the next chapter, we shall be solving important numericals from the first law. Okay, so we hope that you have find this lecture to be very useful, and it will cater to your needs to a very large extent. And we also request you to tell your friends about this channel, to friends and colleagues ko bhi batai, so that they are also benefited, because everything is available absolutely free of cost on this channel. So in the next lecture, we shall be for solving the problems of first law. So thank you so much.